Good morning, students. Today we are going to do the next part of the political parties, which is a very interesting part, children. This is challenges to political parties. We have seen how important the political parties are for the working of democracy. Since they are most visible face of democracy, people generally blame parties for whatever is wrong with the working of democracy. You might have seen in our country, when anything happens, the first thing we blame is our government. We blame democracy, we blame our government. We forget that this government is the government which we have elected. It is our people's democratic country, but still we blame the government. Now, the people's criticism has focused on four problems. People keep on criticizing the political parties, they criticize the democratic system. So, these people, they have finally have come up with the four problems in the areas of different areas of political parties. And political parties need to face and overcome these challenges in order that to remain effective instruments of democracy. That means if our democracy has to be strengthened, then the political parties have to overcome these problems. Challenges means problems within the political party. So there are four challenges which people have identified. First problem is, or the first challenge is, lack of internal democracy. Within the party, what do we mean by democracy? When we say democracy, we say that every person has equal chances of contesting elections or to take part in the electoral process, to put up their views. So that is what we call it as democracy. But in most of the political parties, we do not see this internal democracy within the party. In the party, ordinary members, they do not get any sufficient information on what happens inside the party. There are many members in the party, but only few members, or you can say the few leaders who are at the top, they have to say everything in the party. They take all the decisions. And even the information does not reach to the ordinary members. As these ordinary members don't have the means or connections needed to influence the decisions. As a result, the leaders assume greater power to make decisions in the name of the party. Only a few leaders have the highest power, and those who disagree find it difficult to continue in the party. I don't want to mention the name of the parties here, children. You yourselves are wise enough to see some of the parties where only few leaders, that too also the top leaders, only those leaders are taking the decisions without consulting the other members of the party. So there are no internal elections. Generally, what is required? Internal elections are required so that they can elect their leader, the party leader, or the other leaders. But in our country, there are no elections within the party. Now, because of this, only few leaders take advantage of this and they always take the decisions. So few leaders exercise the paramount power, means the excess of power. And the people who don't agree with these party members who are at the top level, then they can't survive in this party. So they find it difficult for the leadership. So those people who have their independent views, they are not at all entertained and they are not able to come to the highest level of the party. So what has become more important? More than loyalty to party principles and policies, personal loyalty to the leader becomes more important. That means if you are in a political party, you have to be loyal to the leader. Whether you are loyal to the party or whether you are loyal to the maybe the country, that is not seen at all there. What is seen? You have to be loyal to the leader. Then only you can survive in the political party. Now, it's not only in the political party, children. It's there everywhere. In every field, we see that. So, but we are doing since the chapter of political parties. So, I am restricting myself only to this topic of the political parties where a person has independent views but cannot express those views because you have to impress your leader. That has become more important in our country, to impress the leader. Not the government, not the country, not the people. So even if the members are not serving the people, no problem. But the members have to serve the leaders of the party. Then only they can survive in that party. So there is a very good cartoon also over here you can see. If you see this cartoon, what do you see in the cartoon? Who is that person? For you, he may look like a magician, you can see. He is looking like a magician and in hands there are some of the threads and you can see a television and in that you can see some people like puppets. So he is making those puppets to dance. Have you ever seen such a kind of puppet dance? Yes. In our childhood, we used to see a lot of these kind of puppet dances. A man used to come with the dolls and the head is tied with the thread and he used to move those threads in the same way those dolls used to dance. Now, the same way the cartoon depicts a person, Berlusconi. He was the Prime Minister of Italy. He is also one of the top businessmen in Italy. Not only he was the Prime Minister, he was also a very rich businessman. He is also the leader of the Forza Italia, founded in 1993, one of the television channel. He was the leader of one of the television channel. His company owns TV channels. The most important publishing company, a football club, AC Milan, and a bank. This cartoon was made during the last elections. What is shown here, you know, the players, the football players in Italy were in his hands. He used to pay them. He is the businessman, so he used to pay them. So those players had to be loyal with this man. So that is why this cartoon is shown, that how powerful the leaders are of any political party. So they make the members to do what the leaders want to do. So that is what is we call it as the first challenge, where we have discussed that there is lack of internal democracy. Then we continue with the second challenge. Now, what is second challenge? Second challenge is dynastic succession. Now, what is dynastic succession? Dynastic succession means that in some of the political parties in some of the countries, even I'll talk about India also, some of the political parties in some of the countries, we see that only the children of one particular leader, they keep becoming the rulers, whether they have the any kind of an experience or not, but they keep becoming the rulers. Even we say that in democracy, it is the what we call it as a people elect the leaders. But what we see actually in the political parties, in these parties, only the top position leaders, their family members, they become the leaders again. So in one way, we say that it has become again a hereditary system. Like we had earlier monarchy, where the king's son used to become the king. The same way we see that it has become the hereditary system. So that is called it as dynastic succession. Again, in our country, we have few parties where the leader's child is becoming the leader automatically. Example I can give you, we have the Congress party, where we see Jawaharlal Nehru, then his daughter Indira Gandhi, then his son Rajiv Gandhi, now his son Rahul Gandhi. So continuously it has become, not only now in Congress, there are so many state parties also. In the same manner they are working, their family members, the people, those who are very close to them in their family, they are getting the top positions in the parties. And all these positions, top positions, they are controlled by the members of one family. But do you think that is it fair? No, it is unfair to the other members of that party. There are some members in the party who are serving that party for near about 50 to 60 years, but still they don't get a chance to become the leader, but the party leader's son or daughter, they are becoming the leaders, just, or their family members, just because they are born in that family. But children, this is bad for the democracy. It's not at all democracy. It has again become a monarchy system. Because here, people who do not have experience, who do not have any popular support, they are occupying the positions of power. Even if they don't know, they don't have any experience of ruling the country, they are becoming the leaders of our country, which is again a negative factor for the success of the democracy. So what the challenge we are facing is dynastic succession. So we need to remove this challenge. When we remove this challenge, then only we say that our democracy is successful. So that is your second challenge, children, dynastic succession. Third challenge, also we all of us many times see and witness also, that is your money and muscle power. Now what I mean by here, money and muscle power, these two things mainly we see during the election process. Money and muscle power, these two things mainly we see during the election process. What happens in our country, whenever there are elections, there is always a race to win the elections. So, parties are focused only on winning elections. They don't bother how they are winning, but their main aim is to win the elections. So, they tend to use any kind of shortcuts to win the elections. So they use many kind of tricks, many kinds of methods. They even use a lot of money. They spend a lot of money in during the election. So what do they do with this money? Why do you think that in our country only the parties which have so much of money or which have so much of backup, they are only able to win the elections? Because these parties are backed by some of the rich people and companies who fund these parties. They give the money to the parties to win the elections so that to get some favor from the political parties when they make the government. So what is this? This is the influence of money. And not only that, during elections we see in our country many times the poor people are given some money. They are bribed by some of the political parties and they ask votes in favor of that particular party. Not only this, in India, in some of the cases, we also see criminals who can win the elections. There are many criminals who are contesting elections in our country and also becoming leaders in our country. We all know these children today, you are today's children. You are aware about these things. If I ask your class children, how many of you want to enter into politics in our country, there will be hardly one or two hands, maybe even not that. Why? Because we know that there are dirty politics. If you have to survive in the politics, the leaders or these members, they are using money and muscle power and so many other methods to win the elections. So it's not only India. All the democratics all over the world today are worried about the increasing role of these rich people and the big companies in the democratic politics. If you talk about even in our country, there are only two parties which always win elections. Because they are rich, they are being backed by so many other companies, so many big companies, so many big business leaders, they are giving lot of money to these political parties. So that's how this is another challenge, children, money and muscle power, which we have to overcome. Why are we doing this part? So that some of you, those who want to bring change in these parties, should become the leaders and change the system. That is why we are doing these challenges. And we come to the last challenge, which is the fourth challenge, which we call it as lack of meaningful choice. That means parties do not seem to offer a meaningful choice. Now, what I mean by this? Many times, I'll just give an example. If there is a party X and Y, I'm not using the names of the party here at all. So if there are two parties X and Y, I like X party, I don't like Y party. So from my area, I will give vote to a member of X party. But due to some reasons, that member, that party has lost the elections. That party lost the elections. That member has won the election, but the party has lost the elections. And the Y party has won the elections. Now what happens in many countries, we all know, in order to get more majority of the votes, Y party, it will offer this X party member whom I have chosen to shift the party after the elections. And what the X party member is getting for this? He is getting a lump sum of money or some favor. And the member changes the party. Now Y party has made the government, which I don't like. So that is what, now you tell me, where is the choice for me? Where is the meaningful choice for me? I want X party, member and I want the X party to become the ruler party, but this member, after the elections, he has won and he changed his party to Y. So Y party has made the government. So that is how there is no meaningful choice at all, because the leaders in the party, they keep changing the parties. We have been given an example also here, children. In order to offer meaningful choice, I'll just show you this. In order to offer meaningful choice, parties must be significantly different. Their policies must be clearly mentioned. They should be different in their ideologies, ideas. For example, if you have read about the parties, you have seen Communist Party of India, Communist Party of India Marxist. Do you find any difference of ideologies between them? All are same. So which party you are going to choose when their ideas are same, their policies are same, there is no meaningful choice over there. For example, they have given the difference between Labour Party and Conservative Party in Britain is very little. They have not given our country's example. So they have given the Britain's example, that there are two parties there, Labour Party and Conservative Party. Both of them, they say that they work for the workers. It's only the name, children. They actually not. So they say that they are working for the, they are working for the upliftment, or working, they are the workers' party. So hardly there is any difference in their policies or ideologies. So they agree on more fundamental aspects, but differ only in details on how politics are to be framed and implemented. Only what policies have to be made, that is little bit different, but their ideologies, everything are same. So in our country also, most of the major parties you will see, all of them, they have same kind of policies. Or they make same kind of economic policies. Both of them, they say, for example, all the parties say that we will remove poverty, we will remove unemployment. So there is nothing different in their ideologies. So those who want really different policies in India, those who really want different policies, they have no option at all. If I want to choose a party which gives me a different types of policies, there is no such party. Sometimes people cannot even elect very different leaders, as I told you, X and Y example, because the same set of leaders, they keep shifting from one party to the another. You might have seen, again, I'm not naming any of the political party leader. There are some leaders who keep shifting from one party to the another party. They keep shifting from one party to the another party. So if as I already discussed in the X and Y example, I don't want the leader whom I am choosing should go to the Y party. But if that leader is going to the Y party, then where is the choice for me? I don't have any choice at all. So there is again a cartoon over here in this page. This is again a very good cartoon, children. And try to read the cartoons, children. You should be able to read them. You should be able to properly elaborate them. What is that cartoon showing on? You know, this cartoon was drawn during the presidency of George Bush of the Republican Party in USA. The party symbol is elephant. The cartoon seems to suggest that the corporate America controls all major institutions of the country. You know, in America, president has all the powers. There is parliament there, Senate is there, but powers are in the hands of the president. So everything, legislature, judiciary, executive, all of them are in the pockets of the president. So that the cartoon is showing that. That is the cartoon which is showing over there. So you can further, you can even analyze and on according to your own analysis you can do. So that completes the challenges of political parties. And we have few more cartoons also. A lot of cartoons are there. We'll discuss again all those cartoons again. You can see here. See, this person is giving some affidavit. You can see. You already have so much money. Why do you want to contest the elections? Do you have you are you able to read this, children? The cartoon is about that is about all about that those who are coming into politics, they think that we can earn more money through the politics. That is why today many of them are coming into politics. The thinking is like that. And the cartoon, the boy is saying in that purple box, you can see. Does this suggest that in democracies, people contest elections only to make money? Nowadays, yes, many of them are coming into elections to make money only. But isn't it true that there are politicians committed to the well-being of the people? Yes, children, there are some politicians who are committed, who are coming into politics to do some welfare of the people, but some parties don't allow them to do so. Because some parties are so big and so much of money they have, they don't allow these common people to come into politics and do some welfare for the people. So that completes this part, that is the challenges to the political parties. Because in the next part, we will read about how can parties be reformed? Till now we studied the challenges, problems of the political parties. Now we will study remedies. Now whether the remedies were effective or not also we will do. So we will do this in the next video, children. How parties can be reformed. Some suggestions are given by people. Some of the amendments are made by the constitution. Supreme Court has also given some of the views how to reform these political parties. But I feel reforming of political parties entirely depends upon the political leaders. If they want to change, yes, there can be change in the country. But if they don't want to, then there can't be any change. So let's discuss about this interesting part in the next video. How can parties be reformed? That's all, children, for today. Read all those four challenges. Try to write on your own these challenges with examples. So that's all, children. Have a good day.